Hey guys, Bassmaster Elite Series Pro, Wes Logan here. I want to talk to you a little bit about fishing in the springtime. And when I say springtime, we're talking water temperatures from anywhere from 50 to low 60s. Depending, no matter where you are in the country, that's going to be your springtime temperature. That's when the bass really get to thinking about spawning, you know, moving up shallow, getting on their beds, the males move up first, all that good stuff. So pretty much your early spring is going to be your low 50 degree water temperature. That's going to be hardcore pre-spawn 90% of the time. So basically how I'm going to approach a lake or any body of water I'm on that time of year is you want to find places that are a little bit protected, I feel like. And one little key that I try and like doing a little bit of map study, if you can ever find a place that's, let's just say you've got a main reservoir and you have a branch off of it, like a big bay or anywhere that they would be potentially spawning in. Well, if you can find one that runs back north, it's going to be protected from a north wind, which is going to be your normal wind in the wintertime, you know, coming into spring, which is going to bring that colder air in. With that being protected, it's going to be protected out of that wind. It's going to be going to get a little bit warmer if you get a real bright sunny day. So that water is going to be a little bit more consistent, a little bit higher in temperature, and the fish are going to gravitate there first to, you know, start their spawning process. So that's a good place to start in that early spring for, you know, just trying to get an idea of what the fish are doing, kind of trying to figure out what they're holding on. That's kind of the places you would try and start. So moving into what they would be holding on particular, and what I mean by that is like what you would be targeting, like shallow cover most of the time that time of year. Or you can those same type of places, you could find places they would set up, like going into like the mouth of that would be a high spot, or the main lake points, but anywhere going into those places that are going to be protected from that wind. As far as cover goes, I'm going to be looking for most of the time anything hard. It kind of depends on what reservoir you're in, or, you know, body of water. If it's majority of grass, obviously you're going to be focusing on grass. And from a grass standpoint, they can either be in the thickest grass where there's a bunch of it, or the vice versa. There'll be a lot of grass and you try and find where there isn't any grass, where there's voids in it. It'll just kind of depend on how much is there that time of year, and, you know, how the fish are relating to it. And you'll have to have the fish kind of tell you what you're looking for when it gets to that situation. From a hard cover standpoint, you know, you'll have, you know, lay downs is a really good one. Rocks are probably the biggest key in the early spring. And if your lake has docks, that can be a really good pre-spawn setup place. From a bait standpoint, you know, any type of reaction bait is probably going to be your best bet. Cover water, but cover water thoroughly. So you're going to cover a lot of water, but fish it fat, like, you know, you want to kind of pick stuff apart because they may not be very aggressive. So if you have a really high percentage, you know, piece of cover, like a big lay down on a little bitty point or something, you want to throw three or four times across that different angles, and you may get that fish to react from a different angle, you know, or a different speed, something like that. That's going to be kind of the gist of the pre-spawn. Just find places that are protected. Reaction baits are a big deal. Red's a big deal in the springtime, color-wise, any type of bait, vibrating jig, you know, square bill, flat side, lipless bait, all of those are really good. I will have a flipping bait on most of the time, a jig, in the early spring, just because it seems to get a bigger bite if you do get one, but normally you don't get very many. Transitioning into that, you know, that water temperature that's, you know, that 55 to 58, 59, where, you know, the first few, you know, they're starting to like creep up there. You may be catching a few, you know, male buck bass on the real obvious stuff, like where some beds would potentially be. This is probably the best time to catch some of the biggest fish in the lake as they're pulling up shallow, because a lot of times I've seen that the bigger fish in places tend to spawn first. And I'm talking about your, depending on where you're at, whether they're 5 or 6 pounders or 7, 8, 9 pounders, they always tend to spawn first. So that's going to be your best opportunity. And that's when I really like to focus hardcore on the, you know, the bank structure. Places that are, you know, you might have a place, let's just say the edge of a seawall where, you know, a bed might be, and you might catch a 13-incher there. Well, if you have a dot right beside it that's got a little bit of water on it, that could be where that female's setting up, and, you know, you actually catch a 6 or 7 pounder that's waiting to ease up on the bed, whether waiting on a full moon or anything like that. But again, that's where I really like to, you know, focus on the hard cover on the bank, not as much as the, you know, the offshore stuff. Start pitching around a Texas rig when the water gets that temperature, because, you know, they're in that spawning mood. They're really not wanting to eat. They're not very aggressive. So that Texas rig kind of tones it down a little bit, and you tend to get a few more bites. A wacky rig's really good going into the spawn. A buzz bait can be really good depending on what part of the country you're in, what kind of fish you're dealing with.
though.
I'm trying to think. Buzzbait's a really key deal in that early, you know, early spawning situation, that 58 to 60. It can get you some really good bites, but that's kind of how I kind of approach it. Late spring, this is going to be full blast, you know, hardcore on the bed. You know, they'll be laying everywhere. You're looking forward to that full moon or a new moon because you're going to have a new wave pull up, you know, anytime, at least two times per month. And then in between those, you'll have stragglers, you know, playing around, you know, doing their deal, garden fry, garden the nest, and all that good stuff. Wacky worms are a really big deal. A Zoom Slinky is kind of what I like to throw, just weightless on a spinning rod. A Zoom trick worm's really good, just rigging it weightless Texas rig. If you've got a lot of cover, bank grass, or bushes or anything like that, that's a lot more efficient to throw than the wacky rig, but it just gets a lot of bites. They can't really stand it. Again, they're not wanting to eat, they're just trying to protect in more of a protective mode. That's a really good deal. A pop-r can be really good. And again, just pitching around a Texas rig. I still am shying away from the jig on that deal. And then you're gonna have your full-blown sight fishing. So, and again, this is all going on from the very beginning of the protected places. They're gonna be your first, but as we get into this water temperature, the whole lake's probably gonna come into play. But that's kind of how I break down, you know, the springtime from pre-spawn to full-blown spawn, and a little bit into the post-spawn. But there's a transition from spring to summer on that post-spawn deal where even the late spring, you'll be dealing with some post-spawn fish, but they'll still be, you know, relating to a spawning situation, whether it be their bed or anything like that. So from a bait standpoint, all those are really good. You just kind of have to get the fish to tell you what they want that particular day. And the big thing in the spring is the fronts. When they can come in, they really affect it more than any time of year, just because the fish are trying to get up their shell, trying to warm up because it's been so cold all winter. You get a cold front end, stuff really starts to slow down, and sometimes it'll set the fish back, you know, a week and a half to 2 weeks, just depending on how severe the front is or how much flooding you get. But again, that goes back to finding those protected areas. If you have some fronts roll in, just revert back to where you started with the pre-spawn deal if you've gotten into that, you know, spawning situation. If you get far enough along in the spawn and you get some, you know, a weather day or something, it may only affect them for a day or two, not as near as bad as it would early in a pre-spawn situation. But hopefully that helps on a spring fishing situation for you guys. Be sure and, you know, get out there and get after them. But all those baits, all those places, that's what I look for. And I hope this helps, and we'll see you guys next time.